I made a video on this a while ago, but to summarize, this little dongle is called the rtl-sdr. It's a software-defined radio, meaning it can receive a very wide range of frequencies, and it's up to the software on your computer to interpret that into something useful. This was inexpensive and came with an antenna and everything. I can listen to ham radio, FM radio, etc. The problem with this setup is that I can't receive low-frequency signals like shortwave or AM radio. I mean, I can, but it's really hard to get a good signal. Part of this is because of my SDR, and part of this is because of my antenna. The RTL-SDR isn't good at receiving low-frequency signals, and you have to switch sampling modes and all that. There's a ton of interference, too. To remedy this, I got this up converter called the Ham It Up, which basically shifts all frequencies up by 125 MHz. This brings all the low-frequency signals into the range that my SDR is better at receiving. So, say a 1 MHz signal, which is too low for the SDR, is now 126 MHz. I made a more in-depth Patreon video on this a while ago, which I'll link to in the description. One of my members actually suggested it to me. This takes care of my SDR problem, but my antenna is still not right. I'm still using the antenna that was bundled with the SDR. It's your standard rabbit ears. This is just fine for receiving FM radio and higher frequencies, but I need an antenna that's meant for low frequencies. I think it'll need to be longer. The antenna should be a quarter of the wavelength for it to be most efficient, from what I gather. FM radio has a wavelength of about 3 meters. Now for AM, the wavelength is much bigger. We're talking about 330 meters. That's almost 1,100 feet. So 3 meters versus 300. That's why my antenna isn't working well. It's not even a quarter of that wavelength. Instead of buying tons of wire, I ended up just getting this loop antenna. The MLA 30 Plus was recommended by a few people and it was $50, so I decided to pick it up. Let's open this up real quick. Just doing it outside because I'm going to set the antenna up outside. Plastic inside. Okay, so it is quite literally just a loop of wire. And then this says receive only, so don't transmit over this, which I'm not going to do. MLA 30 plus, active loop antenna, frequency range 0.5 to 30 megahertz, which is pretty good. And it looks like this is the amplifier part, and this is probably the power injector. Of course, no instructions except for a warranty activation. Okay. And here's something I've never seen before. A few days after buying this, they actually reached out and said, hey, thanks for ordering this. Let us know if there's anything wrong with it. If there's any flaws, just contact us directly. And then they attached a PDF of the manual. I mean, that's going above and beyond there, asking if I have any problems with it. But it's a little weird they attach a PDF of the manual instead of just providing it. Okay, so what I gather is that we have this loop, right? And then I expand this out. This isn't the actual diameter of it. I'm going to expand this out and then put it on top of some PVC pipe. So I have PVC pipe that I just cut a tiny little notch on just so the wire will sit on it. And then it needs to be 60 centimeters diameter. So, and then I put this on the base here and then these hook on here like that. Okay, we want 60 centimeters, which is right here. Meaning the wings on here need to be 60. Okay, that's done. This is not gonna be the most good looking one. I would have loved to use zip ties, I couldn't find any. But yeah, alright, let's get the wire on here. Okay, not my finest work, but it'll hold. This is more just temporary too, just to test it out. And there's the extra wire hanging off, ready to go. Hold on. This loop has a 60 centimeter diameter, which is only 188 centimeters long, or about 6 feet. That's nowhere near 80 meters. This was something that I realized while writing the earlier part of the script. I initially thought that purely the length of the antenna was what made this a good antenna. I realize now this is not 80 meters of wire. I know professionals have probably already commented on this. Anyway, I thought it was just coiled like that to be more compact or something, but no. This is nowhere near a quarter, or even an eighth, of the wavelength. I don't remember anyone talking about this in high school physics, but the loop antenna is picking up magnetic fields. Yeah, it turns out they call it an electromagnetic wave, since not only does it change electric fields, but also magnetic. I never really thought of this. So instead of it trying to pick up electric fields like my rabbit ears, it's trying to pick up the magnetic field changes. It's in a loop so it can cause induction and all that stuff. Kind of interesting. Anyway, now I actually want to test this out. Okay, so we got the ham it up, the up converter. And then this is the power injector. Reminds me of a TV amplifier. It basically sends power out to the antenna and then sends the amplified signal to my receiver. And here's the rtl-sdr dongle. So I'm going to screw this little coupler in there. And then I'm going to put it on the input side. And then on the output side, we're going to put this little short coax cable into the dongle. And then here's the antenna wire. I'm going to try screwing it in here and ended up having to rearrange this. But again, power, up converter, dongle. Okay, so we got the antenna set up. I can even toggle the amplifier on the ham it up. I'm not going to do that yet. But if you remember from any of my other videos, this is basically all the different frequencies represented, and here's the amplitude of it. So you can see there's some that are spiking here. So let's actually go over to the AM radio band. Wow, that's a lot of stuff. Okay. Now if I click AM as our radio mode, you can see extremely strong these AM radio stations are coming in. Let's go to this one here, and I'll unmute it.
Don't send me any type of text there. That's just for audio. Audio only.
So it's coming in really clearly, and I'll compare this to what it looked like with just the antenna, the rabbit ear antenna that was included. Okay, so we got AM radio taken care of. The signal, the noise on this is insane. I'm hearing stations that I couldn't pick up before. And right there, I kicked on the amplifier on the ham it up. So some of these stations are now going like crazy.
They'll have the football when we come back.
Like, actually crazy amplitudes here. Really cool stuff. I'm gonna keep moving along here. So as we go, there's still some like lame interference stuff. So you can see some of these, like this spike just stays the same. So that's interference on my SDR part, but here's stuff that's not from my SDR. So this is actually a time station, and they have other frequencies that'll come in a little more clear. But basically, like your wall clocks and stuff can listen to this frequency and get accurate time info. So when the batteries die, you have to replace them. You don't have to set the clock; it can just know. Pretty cool. There's something else coming in. There's some weird frequency thing that's, don't know what that's doing. But there's so much noise. Look at this. This has got to be from like an LED light or something. I've tried turning off of the lights in my house. Nothing seems to make a difference. I might just go in the middle of nowhere at this point and, like, what is this? What? I don't understand these. Okay, I'm gonna have to do another YouTube video on this. I'm gonna need to research it though, because I have no idea what I'm listening to. Wow, there's so much stuff here. Oh, look. These are playing the same thing. Oh, come on. There's just something there.
Your
What is this? I don't know how to decode it. I'm trying upper sideband, lower sideband. You hams need to tell me what's going on here.
Momentarily, I think was just calling, but he was on right on our lower sideband, so I'll move up one to cause to see if we can get away from that. Anyway, what's up, over?
I think we're listening to a conversation.
Colorado, Utah border. And guys, when I did turn over to Dan, there was a fishing the tolling contact. Let me see, I've talked down here for a minute or two, and
let me see if that station's there now. Tolling contact, please call right here.
Call sign, please, W0FD.
Huh. I think I heard a W call sign, meaning this is coming from East Coast.
We're right on the edge of a broadcast station.
There's a station. Oh man, there is a station calling in there, but I cannot copy. It's just you're not above the noise level. You got a heck of a lot of things going on, and I got to see some of Matt's.
Sorry to cut this guy off, but this is actually crazy. I'm listening to
concrete work and
someone talking, just a conversation over shortwave.
A trip back to Kansas, and I
this is so cool.
Enough to stop in Goodland, Kansas for the night.
So this is upper sideband, right?
They look like apparatus from the little Abner cart. Say again?
So I'm bookmarking these just so I can always listen back in.
WA7E air bubble, howdy Con, go ahead.
Even though I'm not getting the frequencies just right. Oh my gosh. This is a problem I was having before. Look at all this noise. What is this? AC's not on. Gosh.
Going north from LA to Seattle.
I don't. What was that? Come on, cancel. Okay, I'm making this a bookmark. Yes. Okay, I'm gonna move on from this because I want to listen to other stuff in the same video. This is that same time station at 10 now. That looks cool. Look at that.
Radio November stroke Kilo Lima 7. 1, 2, 3. Carl with a K, Illinois. K9 Bravo, Germany Lima. Okay, thank you. 73. K9 Bravo, Germany Lima. Sprint. Thank you, Sprint. K9 Bravo, Germany Lima. Kilowatt 9 Bravo, Germany Lima.
This was in microwave engineering, but I wasn't allowed to do anything. And finally one day my security came through and they said, hey kid, you're going out there.
This is so cool. People are just talking. That sounds like a computer voice.
Kilowatt 6 Juliet Ocean.
Take a sprint contest, Kilo 6 Juliet Ocean. Kilo 6 Juliet Oscar.
Everybody anywhere for a quick contact, please. K6 Lima Lima.
Oh, this guy's asking for a contact.
If I'm out there, I will do that.
Who do I listen to? There's so many. This looks like three people talking over each other now.
Trip down the hall, go ahead.
AXCL Axel in Alaska.
Alaska.
Okay, your number was 3535. Is that a roger?
Roger, roger.
Okay, thank you, Axel. You're number 5151, Dan, Delta, America, Norway, and Charlie Alpha, California. Thank you, Axel. Your frequency.
Someone from California is talking to someone in Alaska.
CQ, CQ, Sprint, Kilo, Alpha, 6, Kilo, Echo, November.
Kilo 3 Zulu Japan, please copy Kilo Alpha 6 Kilo Echo November. You are number 62, and this is Ken in California.
He's contacting someone from Japan.
Kilo Echo November, just like the call sign. All right, Dave, thanks for West Virginia. Frequency is yours. Good luck.
This is so weird. Okay, I'm going to move on because a guy from Japan never responded. Genuinely disappointed. And look how packed this is. What's crazy is all the bandwidth on this is so minimal that you can just have a part that's packed like that. I remember a comment saying that it's funny that we wanted to get the lower band, like do the down converter, because a long time ago you always wanted to go higher frequency. Now, I mean, it's not necessarily the opposite, but kind of. Alright, I think I'm going to leave it off on that note there. I've been recording for a really long time. But yeah, it was really cool getting to just listen in on conversations from around the world. Some of them, I'm not sure how far it was, but I know, you know, shortwave at night will travel ridiculous distances. So definitely got some from across the United States. I think I got some overseas. I don't know. I want to keep learning about shortwave. It's pretty cool. Thank you to my patrons who let me afford a little bit more cool radio stuff. I appreciate it. To everyone else, thank you for watching.